SmartSuite recently put out a brand new feature that makes it even easier than before to work with managing repetitive tasks inside of your SmartSuite solutions. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down for you exactly how you can use this new feature, and it will enable you to create a task one time, and with just a simple click of a few buttons, you will be able to set that task up to repeat indefinitely on whatever pattern or custom repetition you desire. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. At the forefront of our favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite, an incredible software that is a relational database in the cloud that will allow you to put all of your information in one place and collaborate across your team better. One of the best things that SmartSuite does is enable task management. The way that it allows you to track different tasks and keep everyone within your organization on task. But before I get into how we can create these repetitive tasks with just a simple few clicks, I first want to invite you to join me for my automation training. Now, you don't need to know this kind of automation to get value out of today's video, but if you really want to unlock the power of no code, learning no code automation principles is going to be your best friend. So I will grant you that training for free if you sign up at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen, and I welcome you to follow along in your own SmartSuite account. Of course, if you don't already have one, feel free to start your free trial using our link below. Now, anytime we create a new application in SmartSuite, as I've done here, I get the same default fields showing up. So what we have is the title field, the assigned to field, the priority, the status, and the due date. I've moved these things around a little bit for our demonstration today, but this is very, very similar to how it looks when you just create a brand new application. One thing I have done as well is I've gone into my title here. This is my primary field, and I've toggled off the requirement for these different task names to be unique. Because of the fact that I'm going to be repeating tasks and renaming them over and over again, I want to make sure that they can actually have the same name. So go ahead and toggle that off for our demo today. And then let's create our first task. I'm just gonna name this task one. Whatever this is, I will be sure to assign it to me so that I'm not spamming people on my team, and I'll set a priority. In this case, let's go with normal. And you'll notice that by default, a new status comes in and it has the backlog status filled out. You can control this right here inside of the default, right? So the default status of a new task is gonna be backlog. Okay. Now it comes down to due date. And this is where things get cool because I can leverage that repeating task feature. So let's say this task is due on whatever, the 11th of August. Notice that today is the 6th. Well, if you don't look closely, you might miss it, but in the bottom left corner of this window, there is the little repeating task icon. Now, if I select this, it pops up a new little side panel here that allows me to make this task a repeating task. Now there's a lot that we're going to go into on the different settings for these repeating tasks, but at a high level, it's pretty simple. Number one, we choose how often the task will be repeated or recreated. And what this really has control over is the due date of the task. So here we are, we see that this particular task in question is due on the 11th. Well, if we move forward with these default settings, this will be repeated on a weekly cadence, always due on Friday. And the little calendar here on the left is actually giving us a heads up of what that's gonna look like. So this particular task is due on the dark red, the 11th, and future repeating tasks will be due on the shaded red here, the pink, which is the 18th, the 25th, and I can continue to cycle through all the different months to see that basically every Friday, this task will be reassigned and due. So that's great. Now, notice that the thing that will trigger the automation, that will initiate the fact that we recreate this task, it all comes down to this right here. The status is set to completed. This is what's going to initiate the creation of the next task in this cycle. Now we can also choose here, what is going to be the status of the new task we create? Now notice that this is different from the default setting of the status field. So by default, you already saw that when I created a new task, it came in as a backlog item, but I can choose that this particular task might have overridden permissions. So for example, it might come in and already be in process when a new task is created in this cycle. For us and for our example, I'll keep it at backlog. And then we also get to control what fields are going to be copied over. So for us, we have all fields toggled by default, but you can override this. You might say, I only want the assigned to person and the priority, for example, to be brought into the next variation. Now, one thing you don't see on this list here is the actual name of the task. And that is going to be recreated regardless of what we choose here in our settings. So let's go ahead and move done. And just for the sake of our example, we will go ahead and try this one out. Now, bear in mind, it's going to be repeated every week. So a new task will be added for the next Friday. And the thing that's going to initiate that is when the status is set to completed. So let's go ahead and say we're done here. And this one isn't due for another 5 days, but maybe I got ahead of my work. I'm ready to show it off. I mark this task complete, and it's that simple. I am now initiating the automation, and we're gonna see in just a moment that the new task will be created here, and it will be assigned to, there it goes, August 18th, which if we drill in here, we notice that this is the following Friday. So what I want to point out here is that we are not bringing in any formulas or anything like that. These dates are malleable. We can update this due date. I can move it around and say, actually, this is due on the 16th. But notice that when I do that, because I've set up a recurring task, it's still going to create another one for the following Friday. That is the behavior of this task, the end, right? This, the way I've set this up to be repeating, it's always going to have that action. So we can go ahead and mark this done. And here I am, I can complete this one again. And because of the fact that I moved the date over, the next task that's created will now be due the 18th. I can mark this one complete. The next task that is created will now be due 7 days later on Friday the 25th, as you see right here. So great first step here, but we can go even deeper than this. Let's drill in a little more. I'm gonna create another task here. This will be task two. And again, because I don't wanna spam my team, I will be assigning it to myself. This one now with a high priority, and give SmartSuite a second to settle that in to our view, and there it is. Now, we have the other option of saying, maybe we have something that occurs on the 10th of every month. So I can set up repeating tasks similarly here. Simply say when my due date is, the first one that is, and then go into my repeating task and say, well, not a weekly cadence, but monthly. I also have the option of daily and yearly. They all work in a very similar way, and they all dictate the cadence at which we will be scheduling the next due date, the next task. So for us, if we have this thing that's due on the 10th of every month, we simply say monthly, same day each month on the 10th. Now I can also say something like the second Thursday or the first day of every month or the last day of every month. This is really helpful in the case where maybe we want to bring something in on the last day of the month. And in the case of February, we have 28 days versus 31 days or 30 days in the other months. And so last day of the month is going to always just be added at the end. Second Thursday, as you can imagine, is always going to pick whatever that second Thursday is. It's just an easier way of scheduling out our different items here. So lots can be done here with the monthly decision. But one thing I do want to highlight is that SmartSuite does not yet know what day of the week, or rather, at least it won't show us what day of the week that comes up on. In the case of the 10th of the month in September, the 10th is a Sunday. Unfortunately, there is no setting here that says, I want you to put this on the 10th of the month unless the 10th is on a weekend, in which case I need you to rewind to the previous weekday. That does not yet exist. I'm sure in time this will be enhanced to include that, but right now we don't have that option. So in the case of where something is due on the 10th of every month, unless the 10th falls on a weekend and therefore we need to get it done the Friday before we leave, we would need to come in and manually update this particular task. So in our example though, let's imagine that we're good with the 10th of the month, regardless what day of the week it's on. As you see here, once I move this to complete, what's gonna happen? We're gonna recreate this task due for September 10th in just a minute. Let's go. And there it is. Now we have some other options as well. Let's go ahead with one more task. This is going to be task 3, again, assigning it to myself. And for this one, we will set it to be a low priority. Now, once we allow SmartSuite to settle that task in, notice that I can come in here, pick whatever date I need. What I want to point out for you is that here on the repeating task element, if we are going with a daily cadence, we can, in this case, set it to skip those weekends. So we have the capability of skipping weekends in a daily cadence. As I mentioned, though, it's not yet there for the monthly cadence that I was demoing earlier, as well as, you know, like the yearly cadence and things like that. Yearly cadence, by the way, if you're not exactly sure what it is, it's literally going to just plan this thing out 1 year from the previous date of completion. Not a whole lot of imagination in that one. Now, the other two that I really want to focus on here are your final two options that are getting a little more complicated. We have days after completion and also custom. So days after completion is kind of straightforward, but this is going to be due a certain number of days after we completed the task. So for example, if we complete the task today on the 6th, even though the due date of the task is the 7th, I can set this to say, well, I need my next task to be completed 5 days after that. So let's actually test this one out and say done here. So again, this is not due until tomorrow, but I'm gonna mark it complete now just to test out how this days, relative days inside of my due date works. So notice that I went from the 7th to the 11th, which is a 4-day difference. And this is due to the fact that if I drill into my repeating task here, I am going to create a repeated task 5 days after completion. And so I completed on the 6th, which meant that my next one would be due on the 11th. So this might be helpful in the case where you have things that are kind of due in a variable cadence where you're like, hey, whenever that other thing gets done, that's when the next one is going to need to be put out there. Like we have a next one and it's going to be so many days later. So there we go. That is how we can leverage that one. Let's build our fourth and final task now and look at the most complicated of these options. And this again, I will assign to myself with a normal priority here. Let's load that up. And inside here, we can make any selection, let's say the 14th, and I can drill into my repeating tasks. And now I'm looking at my hardest repetition pattern, which is custom. This is where I can really go next level. Note that I can say every number of weeks or every number of months. So I might say every 2 weeks this needs to run, and I can select specific days of the week that it needs to occur on. Now this is a little more complicated, so let's make sure that we're looking at our calendar guide over here. I could say every 2 weeks repeating on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, which means that literally Monday, Wednesday, Friday will get scheduled, then we'll skip a week. Then Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then we'll skip a week, etc. So you can get pretty granular here in terms of different cadences, different repetitions that might occur inside of your organization. You can get as granular as you need to get these tasks on repeat for you. I know we went pretty quick in this video, so if you have any questions that we did not cover, please be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.